I got a feeling. I've got a feeling.
I've got a feeling. I've got a feeling.
I got a feeling.
Woo! Round of applause for Nana.
Enjoy the musician. We are going to start with a prayer. And since I'm called Joseph, I believe I have the anointing to pray. Because Joseph in the Bible didn't only understand dreams and interpret them. Joseph in the Bible ended up being the father of Jesus as well. So I think I have enough inspiration to pray. So please let us pray. Father, thank you for bringing us here. Thank you for a great new year. Thank you for the friendship, the love, and the creative juices that you sent through us. Tonight, we commit everything to your care. Help us have a great event. And when we auction the book, touch the people's hearts to buy the book, not in cities, but in British pounds. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. At this point, I'd like to invite my very good friend and my caravan roommate, also a very good writer, a tourism avatar, a tourism Nani Matengere, a tourism Otokinatu, Mr. Kofichikata. Did I say Kofichikata? Kofi Akwabi, yes. You know, the Chikata and Akwabi, they're all tourism avatars. And Amaka is looking at me, so the spirit flows like that. Please put your hands together for Mr. Kofi Akwabi as he comes to introduce.
Wow. Hello, everyone. Okay. It's an honor to introduce the chair and guest of honor for tonight's event. Nana Damwa said he wasn't going to put me on tonight's program because he didn't want to be accused of nepotism. But when it got to who introduces the top two guests for today, he couldn't help but say, let's play a little, not Kokofu, but Kotowabi Bobo. So he bent his own rules, and so here I am. And like we played football in the sands at Kotowabi long ago, I'm going to go about this task in a Buga Buga stomach direction, unconventional way. I have two people to introduce. I'm going to put them together, and then off we go, in the spirit of tonight, because I believe it's a family gathering. I'm here to introduce two people. One is a man, the other is a woman. Easy. One of them is a proud royal from Aplau traditional area with the title Mama Jamado the First. The other is a proud son of a Presbyterian priest. And judging from the way things are going, he himself might end up a priest one of these days. Can the church say amen to that? That's a prophecy. One of them is someone who is passionate about social life. So we will say that she has just dignifiably served out a political appointment in the capacity of Deputy Minister of Tourism and the Creative Arts. The other has not held any known political office, but he can be political. Going way back, both of them have had a stint with the National Film and Television Institute, that's NAFT. Both of them are also into TV production, they've done TV production at various levels. Many of us do not know it, but if you remember By the Fireside, one of them was behind it. The other is also behind some powerful TV productions such as Build Your Arc and Thank God It's Friday, which I had the honor of being a star guest on two occasions. Both of them are into serious acting. And when I say that, I mean across the spectrum, name it, stage, television, movies, they've made impacts there. Both of them are strong social advocates, empowering the youth. Both of them are entrepreneurs. One being a CEO of Values for Life, the other owning Safa Company. Both of them are serious, family-oriented individuals. Parents, not only to their biological children, but to many young Ghanaians who look up to them. Both of them are voracious readers and book lovers. So you can understand why we love them so. Ladies and gentlemen, with your permission, I wish to introduce the guest of honor for today. The king of satire in Ghana, king of comedy in Ghana, the numero uno, Kweku Sintin Misa, KSM. Now he's here with the wife. So please, madam, if you can just show us a wave. I know. Thank you. It's also my pleasure. So, madam, we won't leave you alone there. Please kindly join. Okay, I accept defeat. This is Kutubami Bogo, so once in a while it happens. I also have the pleasure to present to you the chairman, the chairwoman, the chairperson. I told you this is Kutubami Bogo, but it's all goes. This lady, I can see, but it's so easy to tell her, I love you. Take it easy. I would like to introduce with pleasure, Honorable Obapa Mamaga, Lady General Abla Diva Gomashi. Madam Chair, audience, your chair, madam, your audience. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Kofi. You know, this week I've met KSM three times. This is the third time I'm meeting KSM this week. The first was at the Bamboo Center, where Chief Mumin launched the Rockwell Jacket Theater Series, Ghana 60. And KSM was there to support with his family. Mamaga is somebody I was going to send an email to earlier today because she's the patron of Inshona, a group that cleans beaches and promotes beach tourism. So I'm glad to have the two of you on the same seat. Please give them a round of applause once again. Before we get the chairperson's response, we'll invite Theo Ayi to come and give us some poetry. Please welcome with a round of applause.
Good evening. The last time I checked, Parliament has not issued a law against polygamy. I thank God for the privilege to be a part of what He's doing in the life of our dear brother, Nana Damwa. We go way back. We used to tell anyone who will listen, come to Jesus, He will set you free. And we did that for years. And it's a privilege to be here tonight. If you take an expression through your mind, I believe you will observe there are many tales that can be told about you. Specifically speaking, let me say that you are a bundle of incense, just like me. And it is our engagement and what you people may know or feel. All together that paid a need for incenseism, which is a study of incense Ghana style. They make us proud. I want to encourage you with a poem titled The Laughter of Tears. To say, even as the incense of the world make you cry, it is possible to make laughter out of them. The laughter of tears. I cry, not because I'm weak, but to reflect my nature. A baby, grown, an adult, happening. Am I mature? I'm a timber rooted in the breast milk of a working mother, a bearded baby. I'm a diapered woman. I'm a bother. I'm an old horse driving convoys of flaming chariots in desert storms. Poisoned arrows lie buried in my intestines like man-eating worms. I cry to release the foul bird that hatches its eggs in my bloodstream. To say what my lips cannot, I cry. I scream! The grammar of tears lies beyond the syntax of language. Crying is a language superior to what feeble lips can utter. The mouth spills its words, the heart its tears. Words are bondage, tears deliverance. Words are torrential rains destroying harvested grains. Tears are the refreshing dew that moisturizes roots better. Tears open the heart to receive sunshine. I cry to set me free from the hole of words. My tears are the canvas on which I paint my words. I cry when I slip down the slimy slopes of sin's pit, landing in the deep dungeon of Vader's hold. I cry when my repentance is accompanied by godly sorrow. That is when tears pour like the monsoon rains. You know, the wise long to decipher the tears of a rumor. They are the wombs of prophecy about pending mysteries and looming help. A woman can bend a bow of iron with her tears, fire bullets with her sobs, whip an entire village into war, and sob her out of pillage. A woman's tears make stronger currents than the angry oceans. A woman's tears are her signature of love for her dear ones, faith in her faithful father, hope in her holy one, grounding in her great God. A mother cries when her child strays into the tentacles of teenage folly. A wife cries when she is dealt a savage blow by the husband who stoops so low to skirts and the forbidden skirts. I learned from her, so I cry too. My tears reflect my fears, falls, and fighting faith, my pleasure and the guilt at the end of it. My tears protect my coming victory, my crown. My tears are earthquakes, springing healing waves to cure heartaches. Every teardrop is a volcano in the path of a tornado. Tears can murder fears. My tears heal the scars of crookedness, restore strength to the fractured arms of love, connect me to the flapping wings of the host above. I have found my laughter in my tears. So now, my smile lasts a mile. In my tears fall all and more. From my weeping soul, all and more. Men don't cry, men don't cry. Bermansu, it's a myth. Even Jesus wept. Jesus wept for Lazarus, my brother, who leapt out of grave's cold. My God swept my sins away with a red room, so I leapt out of sorrow's cold. So my tears will not tear me apart. They herald my coming future. Great, glorious, mature. You may reject me. You can't detect my spirit. You may deflect the favor you need. You can't detect my coming future. Sweet, strong, mature. My tears take me down to the top of the mountain. They wing me till I fly beyond the skies in wisdom. My tears will conquer their hurts. That nears when my glory appears. And when my glory appears, I shall weep once again towards the thrones of heaven in Russia. So my brother, my sister, don't cry no more. For when one door closes, the Lord will open another door. Cast faith in the one who works and be strong forevermore and walk into that door. Cry no more. Thank you.
Please do better for him. That's the man, Flo Ayi. And he was talking about tears and tears and tears. And the woman's tears can, you know, has a power which is greater than that of the waves of the ocean and all that. But that reminded me of something Queen Elizabeth said when she came to Ghana in the 1950s. She said that a man who sheds tears after enjoying a delicious bowl of fufu appreciates the sweat of others. That was Queen Elizabeth in the 1950s. Please, let's welcome our chairperson as she gives us her response.
Thank you very much. Only politics can let Nana and my brother Kofi put me on the same pedestal as KSM. Such effortry. I don't think that that's my place. I'm 2 steps behind him. I'm learning from him. So I'm not his class. I'm not a playful. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is really an honor to be asked that I chair this event this evening. I'm still shorter than the microphone. That's better, thank you. So I scribbled this down just so my thought process will not be distracted by people like Kujo. But I said the trouble with inviting a colleague to your event as a chairperson can lead you to trouble. Because one, he or she will say the things you want to say and are afraid to say yourself, or you think very highly of them. The other reason can be he or she will say what they want and you don't mind because you know they'll say it anyway. And I think with me, the latter is true, that Nana can't stop me from saying what I want to say this evening. And thankfully, I'm not a political appointment now, so well, who cares? It won't go against me. It's already gone against me, so I have no fears. But the other thing is that in both instances, when you accept to be chair or guest of honor at a book launch, then your colleague or your friend expects that perhaps you have some cash stashed somewhere. I think that Nana may have heard that we paid some extra share, so he's invited me here to squeeze a little bit out of me. But I'll pretend that I don't know that we've been paid, just so I can keep it for me and my Akwa people. I haven't published any book of my own. I've been writing a lot. And occasionally I write poetry as well, and I read them. But I think I'm following these young, well, they're not that young. I'm following my two brothers or friends around the place because they are doing what I wish that I could do. So I'm, for very selfish reasons, I'm getting my high from supporting them. After their political appointment, I've heard on many platforms that, oh, and you try to be at every event you're invited to. You all forget that this is my life. If I didn't show up, I wouldn't have a life. So it's for selfish reasons, I get satisfaction from being here. And you are happy that I'm here. So both ways we win. And that has carried me through. And I'm again thankful that I have the opportunity today to come and chair this event. And I have skimmed through the publication and I disagree with a few things. One is the Volta Revolt. Nana? The Volta Revolt is very annoying. It means that girlfriends are enjoying more than wives. I disagree with you. Some wives are really enjoying. And I want to pride myself as one of those wives enjoying. You see, trouble finds itself. The other wife who is enjoying is that one standing right there, Eliza. Yes, because we have support from her husband. Yes, you are one of the lucky men to have your wife supporting you everywhere you go. But I disagree with the Volta Revolt because you are telling me that my people and I, we don't know what we are doing, but I assured you, we know exactly what we are doing. Because as long as you carry a name like Jifa Gomashi, whether you are NDC or not, it will be forced around your neck. So really, what should we do? The other one that I read that tickled me was tribalism is defined, I said, it's tribalism is defined as choosing a workula over Ambisi, dancing to Agbaja or listening to Akalu, then I'm a tribalist. Then I love tribalism. Then I'm practicing tribalism. Because you will choose your food and your song and your dance over mine. So really, what is tribalism? Tribalism for me is just appreciating who you are and what your heritage is. Unless we allow it to get into our politics, of course, that there I agree with you, then it gets murky. The other one is if only politicians had delivered this on a politician. But Nana, I read that one. Was that not a politician who delivered that? Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, just before I cause trouble, any more trouble, I want you to help me accept to honor our brother Nana Redamwa so I can share this to a successful end. I thank you. And hopefully, I'll have opportunity to speak to you again before we leave. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Please put your hands together for her once again. So, Nana Redamwa, no more tribalism. No more tribalism. So, if I visit you next time, you may want to give me the okra, but don't give me the okra. Give me groundnut soup and put some precursor on top, and then add onwao so that it will be water featuring Ashanti, featuring Isti, and then you can choose to serve it with pito or burkina, anything goes, so that we represent the North as well. Now, this event is sponsored by Jamrock. Please put your hands together for Jamrock. This is about the third time they're hosting us. Multipixel, they did the typesetting for the book. Type printed the book.
Biggles printed some of the communication materials that came with the book. Where Ghana? What Nana is wearing, what his family is wearing, my wife Ghana. Club beer as well. When we mention club, we know that the year 1931 has true meaning in the lives of Ghanaians. And then you have Noti Sobolo, we'll be enjoying some of the Sobolo. The book is available on storefoundry.com, which is a Ghanaian e-commerce website built by our own friends. So you can download the book or buy the book on storefoundry.com. AJ's Cleaning Services will ensure that once we are done, this place will return to normalcy. And Masoko Impact are also sponsoring this. They also handle the communication for the launch. I'll tell you about the rest of the sponsors as the program continues. At this point, we'll start with a reading. And one lady who has been causing a lot of trouble on Twitter when it comes to football is here. She'll kickstart the reading, like Cristiano Ronaldo and Messi keep the games in the football she enjoys watching. She's an astute journalist. And one of the, I don't know, at this point, she should be the IGP plenipotentiary because the show she's really known for has educated Ghanaians about the police, the law, and all that. Please put your hands together for Bridget Otu as she comes up to read Asem Baku.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Nana, I would say that I'm very honored and very proud to be here this evening. And at the same time, I feel embarrassed because I have had the opportunity, but I have never really tried to read a lot of our African or Ghanaian writers. And I feel ashamed to say, my favorite author is James Patterson, where there are lots and lots of, authors around. But why is that the case? And can you answer that? I don't know why. Maybe they don't make the books very simple. But I'm very proud of this because Nana's book is so easy to read because I can relate to everything he's talking about. I'm a Ghanaian. I can relate to everything that, he says in his book. And there were lots of chapters to choose from. But I decided to share this particular one with you because I think it made a lot of impact on our elections. And I believe it will make an impact. I mean, in 2020, a lot of people will be talking about this very chapter. It goes like this, a twist of the mouth or thumb. We need to reflect more on the past to appreciate where we are so we can better the future. Many are disillusioned by how our current government is performing. Past government, they lost the elections. And what its priorities are. I say that the shape and beauty of building a determined first at the design stage and then at the construction stage, one can ensure it proceeds per the blueprint. What exactly were you expecting of this government? What did it say it would do? Think back. To campaign 2012, what do you remember as the key promised deliverables, the elements of the contract we signed in 2012 at the polls? What was the blueprint we accepted? A nation does not develop on slogans. Hope is not a strategy. Navigating the economic terrain towards sustainable development is not fueled by euphoric fervor alone. It takes planning. What is Ghana's blueprint for development? What economic models are we following? Where are we going from here and how? 2016 is here, and before long, the speeches and rallies will resume. Ask questions. Analyze what you're told. Raise the bar. Vote for ideas and not just slogans. Don't just twist your mouth or your thumb. We only get what we tolerate. And if we exhibit a craving for Nkatia Boga, surely we'll be fed peanuts or even peanut flavored chickens of nothing. It's a reason my mouth has fallen. I absolutely love this part, this whole chapter. So, Nana, thank you. Thank you very much. And Ghanaians listen to him. Maybe he's a problem. They listen to him and they go to change. So, thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Bridget. Please put your hands together for her once again. But, Nana, the things you've written in this book, I don't know if you've listened to Martin Kassa and the Susu Band song, the same thing. Because that song says that
Smart advice that we should not say everything, but you are writing everything. You're on, Nana. Now, the next reading is by my own senior from Kumasi High School, Osei Kumhaba. He told me that I shouldn't tell people he would probably buy the book for 20,000 Ghana cedis, but I'm saying it because he's a big man. He has money. So please, let's put our hands together for Samuel Pamebuabu as he comes up to read Asemienu.
Thank you, Nana, for the opportunity. I've read through this book twice. I could have chosen every single chapter to share, but there is one that particularly was very striking, because after reading it, I asked myself exactly the same question. And the chapter is on the absurdity of the 21st century tribalism, which was written 15 May 2016. And am I right? Yesterday, I had a chat with a dear friend about an order she had made for an autograph set of my books. When I asked for the name to sign the books to, she mentioned three names, one which means hope in Chi. She explained that hope is her sibling and that their family has some roots in the cabin. This friend has a cancer name. So this new trace was a revelation. I was born and bred in Kutubabi in Accra, but my parents made sure we were connected to our hometown and heritage. I took it from where I heard that my paternal grandpa and maternal grandparents were Wasa. My paternal grandma, my nephew Abakuma, also known as Elizabeth Amamu, I knew was Fanti. Her brother, S. Apia Watson, lived in Akuma Suegu and was a relative my dad stayed with for most of my dad's educational life. Indeed, my dad stayed with his uncle till he completed middle school at Akuma Suegu Kale Middle School. I was told Abakuma's family hailed from Ejumaku. When Nana Wilson passed on, we attended the funeral in Ejumaku. That was my heritage as I knew it for many years. It remains so till some 7 years ago when I learned from my paternal aunties that Abakuma's mom was actually from Asante Valley. Overnight, I realized there were some broken lineages I needed to reconnect to. Anyone familiar with Buno Habu, as we call it, history and folklore, knows some Bunos and I bear common surname. I once asked my dad about any roots we may have in the Bono land, but he was uncertain, although he recalled one of his uncles journeying to Bono to trace his link and never returned. A few years ago, another startling revelation. My older brother, Ntiaku, told my maternal grandfather had roots in Izima. When I proposed to my then girlfriend, wife now, and as I traveled with her to Wasa to introduce her to my parents, I thought about how times have changed. We had emerged from an era where some parents went back to their hometowns to match their sons to selected girls from their towns where their sons came of age. I reflected on how soon sons and daughters are sent miles away to schools where they interact with people from all over the world. Some of these boys and girls are oblivious of the road that leads from Accra to their hometowns. I took home a lady whose parents hail from Winneba and Sokho. And as I combined Wasa, Asante, Fante, and Izima, which tribe do my children belong to? What about those children born to parents of different nationalities and races? That is why modern tribalism amuses me. Many of us don't know the full stories of our ancestral and ethnic makeup. How many of us know, for instance, that the attribute of great height in some Asante families is imported from further up north? Professor H. Percy Brenfell reminds us that the famed chief, Kumboi Kodkene, Nikwapunabwane III, was both Osu Alakamanche and Oyokonjirin of Techiman. As Brenfell says, Niboni claimed both travel. The lessons are here with us again, and politicians will appeal to a tribal instinct as always. Next time one attempts to attempt this old trick and ask if he or she is even sure, ask if he or she is even sure where she, which tribe he or she claims to. And above all, ask yourself, which tribe do your children belong to? And are you even sure? And whilst I shake my head about such absurdity, my mom has fallen. Now, I chose it that I said it relates to me because here am I. My name is Samuel Kwamigwafu. Brought up in Kumasi, but my mom is Fanti. My dad is from Asin. I am married to a woman who is an Ashanti and has an Ashanti, he has an Ashanti father and a Nigerian mother. Now, taking our traditional concepts, you come from the place where your mom hails from. So my kids are not Fantis. They are supposed to be Ashantis. Their mother is not Ashanti because a mother doesn't come from Ashanti. Now, I understand that the Yorubas also trace their ancestry through the paternal lines. So my children aren't from Yoruba as well. So the question is, which tribe do my children come from? I don't know. Thank you.
Hey, Asimov. If you are here and you are also all stars, like SK Boakye, Manare, and I, please put your answer. All stars for Okrom. So I was born in Kumasi. My mother is supposed to be from Nkrasa in the Bronga Afro region because my mother's mother is from there. Now my mother's father, who was the paramount chief of a tuna, also in the Bronga Afro region, has his father from a village across the border in Cote d'Ivoire. Now, last Christmas, I went to visit my father, who is from the border region, and about 5 miles from his village, you enter Bota Riti or Tariba, you enter Togo. And his mother is from Togo. So if you see me eating fufu all the time and praising fufu all the time, it's not that I know where I come from, but fufu gives me my peace of mind. I'm also all stars. At this point, I'd like to acknowledge Leather on Call Ghana. So the first 5 people who buy the books tonight will get something special from them. We also have Copy Play Photography. Now, in the good old days, I would have said Copy Brave. But since he's a health professional, I want to find it Copy Play Flow. That's a great flow. So we also have KBK. They have drinks at the far corner, and you should enjoy their drinks before you leave. We have Aruka, they're also one of our sponsors. And the gentleman, Abeku, is live streaming this. Please put your hands together for Abeku. I've been told there are about 6,000 people watching this. So share the link so that others will also see this particular event. We shall call on Obi to join us with his St. Vincent. Obi, if you're also all star, please let us know you are. Is Obi here? Okay, so Obi is not here, so Nenema will give us a short performance and share some good music with us. Please put your hands together for him.
Thank you.
Now, the next person to come up here works to start your company limited. It's also a lecturer at AUCC. When I came to Accra, my first chop bar for food, he gave me that experience. Yes, and on our way to eat that chop bar, we was playing all for you, fufu, all for you, all for you, fufu, all for you. All for you, all for you. Other lights, all for you. Please join us together for Chris Wola. Is it possible?
to do the book review. My fufu partner, Nana Obi Fufu the second, international fufu ambassador.
I am completely innocent. I have no idea what he's talking about. Okay, so the Bakpabli partnership reminds me of a story I was told by my retired captain of the Army Grandpa. So he said his uncle, a fisherman from Anyangi, had gone to visit his friend, a Nigerian, who is also a fisherman. And for dinner, they had epa. You know, those of us from the eastern coast of the water region, maybe in a bar, if you are going to eat a bar, look at the gestures. So you cut the bar and use your tongue to create a hole in it and scoop it. Okay, so this was what the gentleman was doing. And his host could not complain. He wanted to say something because the soup they had wasn't enough. So at some point, he looked at him and said, okay, the curry canoe they make me, let the water finish when the canoe go pass. I have been given the difficult task of reviewing Nana's book. Many, many in Kroko market years ago, when Kwame, Francis, Odinkuma, and his retinue of local wine harvest assembled the people and announced at the village square that Sikaputa had come of age and that she was ready to go to the riverside and fetch her own water, go to the bush and collect her own firewood, and even speak the white man's language and write telegram messages to the Onima in Inisi Bruchi. The ecstatic crowd of citizens chanted and danced in frenzy. They made merry and prayed to the heavens for rainfall. The gods listened. The rains came. And with the rains, many matters. The matters have come aplenty. Matters yesterday, matters today, matters tomorrow. The same thing. Again, same thing. The same shishi adakebu, niyama shishi sumwasi. That is another man trying to speak or read. My mouth has just arisen. In Saint Prisms is not a quintessential non-fiction book. It has no central theme, no traceable plot, no constant setting. It is everything but the regular book. Nana Beredamua Epi, our Lagos pilgrim, uses a very unorthodox style to document an anthology of everything and anything that makes you want to laugh till you cry, or cry till you laugh. The same things you see, hear, feel, and live on a daily basis. Issues that send your pulse racing as though against the same boat. These same matters that make you shake your head in disbelief and nod in agreement in quick succession. From education to health, politics to science, faith to sports, and everything in between. In Sempisms brings to life the varied and sometimes surreal landscape of the 21st century Ghanaian social discourse and the hustle for survival therein. In Sempisms is the observation of an onlooker from close range, taking apart fiber by fiber every single element of the subject he touches on. In the mode of his previous books, his Sempisms is compelling and gripping. Nana Damua's style is non-judgmental. He describes his experiences as he lays on the table consequences of our collective actions and inactions. Perhaps what makes this book a breezy read and keeps you devouring the pages and yearning for more is the courage of conviction, strength of character, and love for motherland that ooze from the author's skin. Nana the Lagos Pilgrim attempts life while admitting its turbulence, melodramas, and misfiring passions. The chapters and the sentences are terse, the language simple, and the structure easy to read. Each chapter opens with an anecdote that makes you smile then your smart face into despair, hopelessness, anger, frustration, as you delve into the meaty substance of each story. What Nana Arel writes about are usually the familiar issues you bump into on the streets of Accra and in the alleyways of Anyako. They are issues you probably raved and ranted about until eventually something more annoying hits the media space. The Sentences is a solid tale of different tales that does not disappoint. It's dramatic, suspenseful. The smooth reading makes it easy to forget the time and keep flipping the pages. Our Lagos Reading knows how to bring the emotions out of the briefest scene. Going through this book, it is difficult not to like the unpretentious style of the author. To be sure, there are some weaknesses in the book, quite negligible actually. By his very style, a casual reader may have to read again and again to catch most of Nana's drift. Ardent followers of the Damwon style, however, will find no difficulties in decoding the Wasserman's lingo as captured in Insane Prisons. Also, even though Insane Prisons is being launched in 2017, some of the issues touched on have happened as far back as 2014, meaning a first-time Damwon reader, or anyone for that matter, who is not abreast of social political issues in Ghana, may have to take a trip into time, in order to relate to the content. Having said that, it is apt to add, nonetheless, that the same business provides a valuable and absorbing window into Ghana, Kwame Nkrumah's Ghana, your Ghana, our Ghana. Whichever way one looks at it, there's something almost archetypal about Nana Arel Damwon's courage to speak his own truth. Magana yaka, my mouth has fallen.
Thank you very much, Chris. I didn't know you could speak Hausa. So if Magana yaka, Mungodi, Aleba Kalaga, Ami. Oh, but we all agree that today is going to be, you know, a unified Ghanaian, no tribalism. So I spoke ever, I didn't speak down. I'll speak down. Yeah, I'll speak down later. Where? Different than my consequences. I guess that's down, right? It's not? It is, right? Different than my consequences. But Nana, how is Archie going? Have you followed up? Well, we move on. It's time to have the same reasons with Obi. Please put your hands together for Obi as he comes up to bring us the same reasons.
Hello, everybody. Hello, this is how you all doing? You are fine, thank you. My name is Obi. I'm a comedian and I'm a doctor too. Yeah, thank you very much. So I'm going to do my version of the SMPs, you know. It's good to be here. I miss people who read other books apart from Facebook. I'm so glad to be part of you guys. I didn't know how to dress, you know, I didn't know, so I just picked some stars and then I walk. But I know you ladies, you dress. A round of applause for all ladies here. Yeah. And real quick, how many of you ladies here wear waistliners? Waistliners, you know, La Paz girls call it bulletproof vest. But I'm not here for La Paz girls, I'm here for you. You. So how many of you wear waistliners? Waistliners, please show my hand. Why do you wear it? Why? Earlier you have a lady and you feel all the mushiness that comes with womanhood. Flesh to bone. But now it's changed. You have a lady, it's like you're having your laptop back. I don't understand. And you know, earlier you could play with a lady, you could sneak up on her and take her, you can't do that anymore, you break your index finger. What is it? I mean, I don't get it. And some of you, the makeup men, now you can't sneak up on you and play tricks on you. You live and a hand is full of paint. Oh,
And the stress the wastefulness put on
your vocal cords. I cannot imagine. I met one lady, I greeted her, hey, how are you? She said, oh, I'm fine. I'm like, wow. That's your voice. She said, yes. And I said, okay, cool. What's your name? My name is Anita. I'm like, wow. We go home, she took off the wastefulness. I said, Anita, should I get you something?
Like, yeah, come on, something.
I'm like, how the hell did your voice change from selling young to Sigamafu in 2 seconds? It's fraud. I think we can see all ladies who were waist trainers, you know. But I love Ghana, and I love my job as a doctor too. The job as a doctor is lucrative and popular earlier. But now, it's just lucrative, it's not popular anymore. You see, earlier you see a parent with a kid, throws the kid up. Kwajo doctor, Kwajo mayor doctor, hey, and the doctor. The parents were doing that. Even when the kid is as dumb as, you know, anything, you know. Kwajo 1+1 is saying, Kwajo say 5, hey, 1 year, but still mayor doctor. Parents were doing that. But now it's changed. Yesterday, I coached from work, I met one parent with a kid. Kwajo, as I'm going, I'm like, wow. Don't let me hear you say, Kwajo, Razak, grandma, man. It's amazing, you know, but most of us have motivations. Your motivations, I was motivated by my mom to be a doctor, of course, not the comedy part. The comedy part is my dad, not my mom motivated me to be a doctor. How many of you have parents in the house who are doctors in the house? They never went to the medical school, but they would attend to you. Yeah, Ghanaian parents, a round of applause for them, our moms. Who, unlike a white setting, the white people go to them, mommy, I have a headache. They won't be like, oh my god, my baby has a headache, oh my god, it could be evil, it could be SARS. She goes to Google, pa, signs of headache, pa, hey, my god, it's asthma, oh my god. And then she picks phone calls, 911, ambulance comes to pick their kid to the hospital. Headache. Come to my house, I have a headache, I go to my mama, I'm like, and then one in. Only in. And I'm now, come in. And amazingly, I go and come and I'm fine. Around the couple of man. Wonderful people. Wonderful. And most of you wonder, you know, so I was motivated to be a doctor because I thought it was easy. You come to my clinic, Dr. Tianya, boss, honey. And then you have a medical same. You know, unlike white settings, white people, there's a 1-to-1 doctor to patient ratio. You know, so you get the time to attend to a patient. Ghana, it's a 1 to 20 million people, right? Doctor, 20 million patients. So a white patient and the doctor can have a discussion. Doctor, what is wrong with you? The doctor will be like, oh my god, it breaks my heart to tell you this, but your lab results are in and you have malaria. That is how they break malaria news. Ghana clinic. The place is choked. You want me to spend 30 minutes on you? No. They send the nurse out with your diagnosis. I love my job, especially when I meet old patients, any of you here, 50 years and above, you are wonderful, man. Especially those of you who work at the district assemblies. Every people can lie. You can ask them, how old are you? I said, doctor, how old are you? And they say, how old are you? Tell me. Because they know they lie about their age. When you ask them their age, they want to lie more. You know, some of them give it to you like you ask them for lotto numbers. Mr. How old are you? So, I'm 40, 45, 50, 55, 60. Strike the average. I'm like, wow. And some of them give it to you like it's a journey they're going through. Mr. How old are you? Oh, it's a CRD. I'm 45. I'm 50. And Chenegu 60. And they're talking. Some of them give you options to choose from. That is what one thing I got to understand. Options.
Like, Mr. Ayin, how old are you?
Dr. Apedien.
And Apedien said, oh, say your own real age. And your one buying here.
Oh, real age, 66. I'm buying 44.
Wow, I need patience. But I only have a few minutes more than I'll be done. But
oh, really?
You guys are feeling me.
Oh, round of applause for me.
Yeah, and I always introduce myself to ladies like, hey, my name is Obi. I'm an eye doctor. But I don't know Ghanaian ladies. Anytime you tell them you're a doctor, that is when they forget about the date you guys have gone and they break their medical history. Like, oh, you're a doctor. Oh, my eye. See, that's been itching. And they start and they break my mommy to her eye. So, like, it's a date, man. So I've changed. You ask me, what do you do? I say, oh, my name is Obi. I'm a gynecologist. Any problem? You don't have any problem? No problem? Okay, let's go. And then it settles the matter. But I love Ghana. I love Ghana because of our tribal understanding. For a better way, if you can give me a better way. Tribal is your master. Not very. Yeah, it's a fool. You know, tolerance. God bless you.
Tolerance.
You know, so I was wondering if Jesus was born Ghanaian. Jesus was born Ghanaian. Which tribe would he be? Oh yeah, yes, in me.
Nah, Jesus will not be Ewe.
No, look. And every man will not be that meek and humble for you to kill him like that. No. You put the nail in April Jesus' hand. You feel it in your ribs. Put the nail back like this. Back like this. Ah. But why are they put the nail for your hand? I bet you don't ask for my permission. Which other tribe? Ashanti. Forget. God will not. Jesus will not be Ashanti. Ashanti person, before you kill him, man, he has to grab to you. That Which other tribe? Hausa. Jesus Hausa. Hausa people, they don't talk much.
You were yelling fast. Come fast, man. He said to me this week, I'm not sure you were lying. You to me, my dear, was lying. No, you didn't do a lie. You are not fast. Come on, man. Come on. Come on.
I believe, you know, imagine Hausa Jesus, like on the cross, and then the guy, Jesus, free yourself. But I believe Jesus can only be a fancy. Rather have a fantasy. Whoa, fantasy, you rock. It's only a fancy man who will be meek and humble for you to slaughter and kill him. Hey, I beg for forgiveness. Thank you very much. My name is Obi. Spread the gospel, man. I'm funny. God bless you.
Please put your hands together for my man, Obi. Obi, you know, let them know if you don't have it. And I'm a doctor, it's a shiny to send your dad, baby. And I know white shirt, you know. No, I don't know if I'm the yellow. I'm so sad white shirt now, actually. But the trousers are not immune. Say if we bought out. Say if we east, you know. Say if we heal. But guys, Obi said something which I think is true. Now, if you listen to radio, you hear all the adverts about why am I beaters, right? So the beaters are actually doing very well. When we were kids, whenever we were there, you go to my mom, Abina. We are wrong. But now, for Atom's class, TV test, never arrived. Now, for MMB 760 down. So she will grind the MMB, add it to the art roots, and give you a spoonful for you to drink. Now, if you give me art roots when I'm suffering from diarrhea, headaches, whatever, why won't I drink the test when I grow up? Because I get used to it. And he said something about Ghanaian footballers, like, oh, mothers now say as a mother. But there's something about footballers which I've noticed. So we went for the under 21 tournament, we did very well, and then we were interviewing one of the footballers, under 21. So, how do you feel? First of all, I want to thank God, I want to thank our coach, and I want to say hi to my daughter who is celebrating her 16th birthday. Ghanaian footballers, no size. We will continue the reading, but before we go on, Haruka, I've been told, has some, what is it? Is it pudding, which they are sampling? We debated this on the City Breakfast Show before, that in Papa, is it pudding or what? So they are sampling some very nice pudding, so you should see the Haruka guys for the pudding. We also have Achedie, you can see all these beautiful furniture made in Ghana. Achedie makes them. So you need to talk to them and get some of the furniture for yourself. And you have documentary, they are videoing this. So very soon you'll see yourselves on social media. The other book that we read, you see the video online. Documentary is videoing this. I'd like to invite Celestine Nudamu to come up next with Haiku. Please put your hands together for Celestine. Now, whilst we wait for Celestine, there's a special guest we have in the house. His name is Mr. Pierre J. When someone was reading his bit, we talked about the fact that Nana is from Zima, from Ahanta, from Jamaica, from all those places. Now, Mr. Pierre J is here. Maybe after the show, we'll ask him which part of the front is it in the life of Nana. So please, let's welcome Mr. Pierre J as he comes up to join us on the night table. He's Nana Redamo's uncle. His haircut looks like the one Nkrumah had on the eve of independence. Nkrumah's haircut, the same thing. And they were singing, Nkrumah show boy, Nkrumah. Please put your hands together for Mr. Pierre J once again. At this point, we shall invite the man who has assembled us here tonight, Nana Are Damoa, to bring us in Sensem. Please welcome him with a round of applause.
Hello, everyone. Good evening. So 9 years after my first book was published, 20 years after my first major award as a writer, which was being adjudged the first prize winner of the Step Magazine National Story Writing Competition, and 22 years after my first short story was published in the Weekend Mirror, we gather here to celebrate together the sixth child from my literary loins. This is only possible because along the route on my marathon of writing, many of you have cheered me on through the gates of thought and as I went through excursions in my mind, speaking of Ghana with satirical incentivisms through many tales. Thank you all. I want to give a special tribute to my wife and children, my mom, my father-in-law, Mr. E.W.K. Richardson, to whom this new book is dedicated. And I wish to state that the historian should please note at this as part of the diary I paid almost 50 years ago. This must go to my credit. My paternal uncle, Dada PJ, who just joined us, who has attended all my book launches, coming all the way from Pristia. And who has given me the target of writing 10 books before he goes to the ancestral village. That I have 4 more to go. My siblings and all of you friends, both far and near, thank you very much. I wish to express my deepest appreciation to two honored guests with us today, both of whom have been mentors from afar and then near. Our chairperson and keynote speaker, Auntie Dipa, Abla Dipa Obasi, and the youngest Oluman Bugi, KSM, who are two legends in their own rights. I feel very honored to have you. My earliest memories of my holy village, my very first faint memories are of asking my late paternal grandfather, Nana Premento, why he was sucking the chocolate bar instead of chewing it. Apparently, his teeth had taken a wasali at the time. I don't recollect what year that was, but I do recollect that in 1980, we attended his funeral in the Propong, traveling in the VW Beetle owned by Ulman Briscoe, the famous Catholic friend of my dad's, and Catholic spelled with capital C-A-T. I recollect the apan that took place in honor of this late Omanhu, and particularly remember tasting duck meat, whatever it is called, apart from Dabo Dabo, which was part of the spoils of the apa. And those who don't know apa, when the royal dies, they set a curfew for the animals. So any animal found outside the pen in the open finds its way on the highway to the royal suite. My next big visit was somewhere around 1983 when we went by a sleeper train, an overnight train from Accra, boarding from Joel Station to Tapa and continuing to perform by road. I recall my late brother Yawapia running after the truck, taking us back to Takoradi from Ekoko as he worked, and this was during the famine of the 1983. He was a student there at Amifimai Secondary School, the local second cycle school to which my dad sent all my siblings who made it to the secondary school so we could reconnect to our roots and not become Accra people. I only changed from Amens to Ghana National because my class 6 teacher convinced my dad to send me to a science school so I could become a medical doctor because I was good at science and mathematics. Amens didn't offer science then. I was later to remedy this deviation from the norm by undertaking my national service after sixth form in Amens between 1993 and 1994 as a maths and science tutor, and also teaching during my first 2 years at the university during vacations. Indeed, my two siblings, Yao and Tiapo, who made it through the sixth form, also did their national service within the same traditional area, Yao at Wasa Isukuma and Tiapo at Wasa in Yebrim. And when I spoke to Tiapo this morning, he told me that in Yebrim is 12 miles by road, sea or air. That no matter where you pass that village, the distance is 12 miles. And it was where my mom taught as a teacher for the first time as well. So that began my romance with my hometown. And when my parents relocated to Wasa Propong from Kutubari in 1987, when I was in Form 1 in Ghana National, I started traveling alone between Accra, Cape Coast, and Wasa Propong, spending many hours on the road. In those days, a journey from Accra to Wasa started at dawn and ended at midnight in the Osa Tata buses. One reached his or her destination either way with a hair colored ginger from the dust. I had many happy times in my village as a boy during vacations from boarding house and during national service days, being taught how to ride a bicycle, how to swim and fish in the Ishri River by my best friend in the village, the Wasafrafra boy called Aboko, who I saw again last year when I visited. Aboko taught me how to speak my mother tongue properly, having been born and brought up in the Propong. His family are very much indigenous of the village. We went together to the village to fetch water for all activities except for drinking, as we usually harvested drinking water from the roofs when it rained. I learned to push trucks, and go to the farms to weed and to harvest. My mom operated a chop bar, so I learned about bushmeat and how to roast and dissect it. Happy moments that built my pride in my holy village. One of the major stories around Wasa then was that when it rained, you could find gold nuggets in gutters. My traditional area is rich in minerals, especially gold, and Galamsey boys were popular there. You would identify them when they walk through town during market days with their swagger, colorful dresses, and bling bling. They made money quickly and spent it quickly, and they were raided often by the police. Even though lucrative, Galamsey was seen as illegal, and the citizens ensured with the police that it was under control. Every year since I finished the university and started working, I have gone back home to visit and for important family events, especially funerals. Even whilst working away from Ghana, I still kept that tradition, taking the children with me also as they were added to the family. I visited my holy village of Asekopon last December 2016, and I was ashamed of what my hometown had become, a Chinatown, with so many Wasanese that I couldn't even see my own people. It had undergone a Chinese invasion with our chiefs in collusion, with Chinese signages everywhere. The rivers now look like milo drinks with expired milk. Parcels of land look like cooked beans mixed with garri and palm oil. Nottingham University has a campus in China and one in Malaysia. It is traditional for students to transfer from China to the UK for a year for their studies, like a study abroad program. One of the strengths of the multinational, multicultural heritage that my alma mater has. So when I finished my course in 2006 in September, I stayed for a couple of weeks helping as a student volunteer for the International Welcome Week for Nottingham University, where we help new international students settle in and get acquainted with the UK, with Nottingham, and with the school. One day, just as we were wrapping up for the day, we got information that two buses of students had just arrived in the school from Heathrow. The buses were filled with Chinese students, full of life and adventure. As an aside, the Asians are really sending their kids to school abroad and really educating them, and this is part of their success story and not a fluke at all. In Nottingham University, we used to say that out of every 5 students we encountered, 3 were Asian and 2 were Chinese. An Iranian friend once joked that he felt like Chinatown. They enriched the programs and were an encouragement to most of us as we struggled through our courses, reminding ourselves that if they could learn to speak and write English, sometimes only perfecting it during their studies in the UK and pass their exams, those of us from Africa who were mostly taught in English from primary school had no excuse not to pass. But I digress. Landing at Putukai International Airport on 18th February, just last week from Lagos, I saw so many Chinese travelers coming into the country that I was reminded of that day in Nottingham. I'm sure many of them will be going to Wasa to continue the gold rush, to continue decimating our lands with our complicit consent. A writer observes patterns and is worried of coincidences. So I find it quite significant that the first foreign delegation to visit the new president on his first working day in office on the 9th of January 2017 was from the Chinese embassy. We read history and wonder why our ancestors sold their kit and pen and cane for rum, schnapps, and gunpowder. Yet today we sit and watch as we sell ourselves cheap to the Chinese and many others by extension and in other activities apart from Galamsey for yen, fried rice, and sweet and sour soup, acting as if we are a people available for rape by the rest of the world, turning our backsides up and supplying our own petroleum jelly. Aren't we ashamed of ourselves?
in some prisons. My mouth has fallen. Thank you all.
Please put your hands together for Nana. As much as I admire his writing and his reading, whilst I was reading, my heart was being broken into pieces because of what he was describing to us. And the story and the events he's described to us are things that some of us have seen. I believe, Kwame Dan, you've seen how Galamse is destroying our environment. Israeli was sitting here. I was with him on a trip to the Western region, and we saw how young men were just doing their stuff in the water bodies, just by the roadside. You report to the police and they tell you, we don't see them all, but these people carry out their activities by the roadside. If a writer's words cannot change the nation, then that writer is of no use. Nana Redamoy's words and his writings are changing us, and he's of more use. Please put your hands together for Nana Redamoy for that delivery. We have the next reading, and please, let's welcome Celestine Mudano to come up and give us the next reading.
From the original 17 syllables to so simple three lines, short, long, and short, mainly about nature. But we in Ghana here, or Native Africa, we have tried to localize it, and we have named it Africa, because our sight and sounds are peculiar to us and not to the Japanese or the Western forms, where they have four seasons. We only have two seasons, wet and dry, especially the Hamata. So a group of us in Ghana, led by Ajay Ban, we have tried to localize this foreign concept to make it our own. So we use sights and sounds peculiar to Africa to write our haiku. We call it Africa. So I'll read a few Afriku and then pure haiku as well. Harmattan winds, coffee aroma, my companion. This is just a three haiku, and it says a lot. Harmattan winds, coffee aroma, my companion. Rustling silk, the sound of leaves in Harmattan. Rustling silk, the sound of leaves in Harmattan. Windless night, the full moon in my barrel. Windless night, the full moon in my barrel. Mirage, the cocoyam leaf shimmers. Mirage, the cocoyam leaf shimmers. Morning perfume. The valley's drums rouse the leaves. Morning perfume. The valley's drums rouse the leaves. Farmland. Sun-filled mangoes track my steps. Warm night. The scattered cloaks and the feast of mosquitoes. Black night. The voodoo priest shivers at the moon. Black night, the voodoo priest shivers at the moon. bamboo flute, rushing string comes the savan. New day, a cock crows tears the leaves. Moonless night, an old mountain dispels the shadows. By the head, a cold breeze sways the loincloth. Red eyes, squeezing juice from stones, refugee kids. Red eyes, squeezing juice from stones, refugee kids. Grinding stone, her ebony hue fades in pepper soup. Grinding stone, her ebony hue fades in pepper soup. Rumbling stomach, counting melons at twilight. Sundown, a mother gathers her unsold lemons. Market day, the stench of unsold wares fills her stomach. These are many haiku with the African background, sites and culture of Africa, things that are peculiar to Africa. There are some that also talk about divinity, should I say, or spirituality. I'll read a few. After the storm, in sprouting leaf, the chaff of Noah's dove. Where is God? Reason flees in the spit of machine fire. Where is God? Reason flees in the spit of machine fire. Edge of skies, raindrop falls as tears. Easter breathing. Edge of skies, raindrop falls as tears. Easter breathing. Concerto, raindrops sing Hosanna. Concerto, raindrops sing Hosanna. Heaven bound, the weight of our sins crush the clouds. Heaven bound, the weight of our sins squash the clouds. Jacob's ladder, the round grown with sins. Jacob's ladder, the round grown with sins. Flute notes, God's breath stirs the dawn. Flute notes, God's breath stirs the dawn. In anguish, my only refuge is higher. A glimpse of heaven through cotton clouds, the palm tree in supplication. Empty tomb, above the echoes, Jesus lives. Ultimate test, in place of the lamb, a ram. Child prodigy, banquet of fish and bread to the rescue. Dark night, coat of many colors lights the way. Dark night, coat of many colors lights the way. Opium, healing the world with the word. Amen.
Please be chance to get up for Celestine once again. We shall have our keynote addressed soon by KSM. But before that, we will have appellations by Fakumpong. Now, I think he's one of the few people coming up here who has something almost written about him. Now, on page 56, Nana writes about Reggie and Poli. Do you remember Reggie and Poli? They played second in the X Factor. Now, Nana says that I first listened to Reggie's song, Virgin. It was a popular song. How many of you remember that song? Men may be a soria of a virgin, sana wa ye wedding. And then he wrote that, you remember the song, You May Kiss the Bride? Check it out now. You may kiss the bride. Oh, kiss the bride. Now, he concludes that what you're working on for which you feel is taking too long to be, what are you working on for which you feel is taking too long to be noticed? Keep at it, many examples abound. Keep dreaming, keep working, keep working. Now, our next performer has been working on his art. He's refined it over the years. His flows are as punchy as Sarkozy's flows. He's as thought-provoking as a Obrafo. And his flow as soothing as Thomas's voice. At a point, there was a golden voice of Africa and as memorable as Amachi Dede's performance. Please, put your hands together for Papin Pong as he comes out with appellation.
And you young fool free. Hey, then you soon are. And you young fool free. Aha. I read a damn free, I read a damn free, I get a little free, I come on two free. Don't find a fool free yet. And Benisi, a son of Sam, son of Assam, son of Sam, son of Sam, son of Sam was Massam, and a son of Sam was Massam, the Pedoman Poma. What's on some so come on? I am in some business indeed. Mama, you read down here and Yansa Pansu, Abdul Yansa Fu, Ebian Yansa Bak, Ama Yansa Bak, Inchesu Pak, Ma Yansa Fu, Enyan Yansa Bak, Apapa Abru Naras of Pasopa Romakra, or Tinting Grammar, what you don't think any measure of my intending opponent about Tinting with everything up with it. Oh, Sasha, and the new is a subject of flat. Near what Nyan's a broom at Nyan's a pin at Nyan's a dumped out. Every Nyan's a little bit up in Nyan's a my Nyan's a side and Nyan's a broom. My Nyan's a broom and Nyan's a phone Nyan's a punch. I'm a young son. What's that? Oh, Nyan's a little Nyan's a broom. And then, sir. Man's answer said, oh, no, I want my young son said, and we answered Groomer. Let's live there and you saw me, and I'm being answered from the answer here, young boy. Yes, sir. And you know, there and you said, Sabbath and flat. A bravo in seven balls, which and Pupo, asking me, I don't do. And I'm sure, so which we go and send peace in the most pop to see us here. Who near Emma Sabe, or Munamu, whom, and a whom, a chinara, who were 2 minutes from plan, who ever there at the air woman, we are talking for them, we are talking here with people of the government, Nara, I will soon bring him. Ain't it, Madawoma, Momayan farmers, a fellow in law in St. Peas in as much company bringing. Join St. Peas in as much pop. Now, when you're in here, when you put a Zenibiara into me, one Casao, Brahma, or Quendia's door. Don't send peas in so much complaining. Now, when you're in here, if it is a thing, who being and Sapongin, Shapongura, and Brapon, Papin Pong, and Jumpong, or Bumbiara, the door. Bora send peas in so much, nye wunye nti a biribiara ntumi nsɛe ɔmampɔn a n'anwempɔn ne abrɛmpɔn ne ɛhene titi ampɔn ne ayiri fi ampɔn ne papadedrampɔn ntoto onyankoropɔn ntweri ampɔn kantankanantisankananti kankankokora mantempɔn kantamanto kanto kankamankam kantankraka titi ne nyansapɔn ne nhyirapɔn papempɔn ase wɔ ne paitro domodo Johnson P's in Sumasuko, Nawinia, Bridiara, and Jimmy Chicha, in May or Manga, Nemanfo, a Chalo Paltro Borasu, Ma or Tangli, a Han Tangli, a Yan Tangli, and Ponton Kranga Fanumu. Fahu Hai, so in St. P's in Smukia, in Plenty, Nawinia, a Bradi Pace, here, when Yes, I'm going to say, I'm going to say, Also, a point near Tabonano. And by the summit of flat, or ten, Mekasa ana mereka di akusi nyaso. Mereka di akusi mangkasa mapra. Eya kwekusi nti misa. Owora kese kone dene mere kurantong. Asamani ba amu ya san samanta ni ofen fen si afan. Om pa fen wo dine mimi. Ni jiren chi ampe. Ni ni chiti jangan le mi adie dinasin mutem. Ni nti jakere nana. O brusia. The home from my teacher of Pa, Chopia, Chopper, my Nasa. You, my brother, who are our own share. Since in Berlin, I'm too. A missan and the number of
It was very, very good to be here. My first time in Jamrock. Show some love for Jamrock. Great to be here. And I just remember, you know, not too long ago, everywhere I go, KSM! You know, every kids, all folks everywhere, KSM! And then all of a sudden it seemed to have changed. Now they see me and they go, hey, Poppy. I get a feeling there's a reason why. Poppy. But it's good to be here and listen to some amazing voice like Theo. Where's Theo? Showing some more love, man. Theo was fantastic. Listening to everything here, I have just one regret, no other one.
you brought tears to my eyes because I regret I didn't follow up on my poetry. Because I think I had all the traces of a very good poet when I was a kid, and I remember my first poem, deep, powerful, incisive, when I was a kid, maybe 9 years old, but it was very, very deep. And when I was reading Theo, I was like, wow, if only I had followed up, I could have maybe been as good as him. Because I'm going to give you the first poem I wrote. And you tell me if you don't think it's deep. I like eating rice, but I fear the price. Whenever I mention it twice, I'll stop eating and rather eat ice.
Thank you.
That was talent in the making. Pure like the victory, I didn't get the encouragement. But it's good to be here and to be invited to be keynote speaker. And I was very interested in one thing, you know, when I read I've known and now read Amor to have a master's in chemical engineering. He has his master's in chemical engineering from Nottingham University, and also his first degree in chemical engineering from KNUSD. And I sent him a text and I said, now just give me a sample of some of the courses you studied when you were in university, preparing for your degree in chemical engineering. And then I said, I was studying things like thermodynamics, fluid mechanics, engineering mathematics, project and design control. And I'm like, well, if I'm supposed to go by the normal profile of anybody who has this background, it's supposed to be like a science teacher, a lab, head of lab technology, something like that. But not somebody who is in creative writing. And that's the part that really struck me. So I started thinking about this whole aspect of creativity and how sad it is that in our parts of the world, creativity and talents in creative writing, we seem to limit that only to those who are studying the arts, if I should say. When you're in secondary school and you're doing well in literature, where arts? You only think of you when as doing science, when you are good in mathematics, physics, chemistry, and the likes. So you're pigeonholed into thinking that creativity is limited to only the creative arts. There are many times I go in schools and talk to kids around the nation, and many times I hear this, Kesevin, I can't sing, I can't draw, I can't act, I can't write, I don't have any talent. Which means talent is limited to the creative arts. But one thing that I've learned from Nana Damoa is that talent and creativity has no limits. Unfortunately, our education system, which for the most part teaches us what to think and not how to think. And when you are taught what to think, whatever creativity is inside you is stifled. So I'm very, very happy to have the likes of Nana Damoa, who are creative this way. And the doctor who just left us, is Obi here? Or he just came in full and he left? I'm saying full with a lot of respect, by the way. I remember I went to the Shell shop some time ago, and this little kid was in the shop, and I was shopping around. The little kid was looking at me wherever I went, you know. He was staring at me, you know. And then instead of pulling their mother's frock, mommy, mommy, mommy. So the mother turned and said, what? So this little kid pointed at me with a big smile. Mommy, they're joker. I I'm telling you. And I thought the mother was going to scold her. Don't call him a joker. That is Grandpa Kersen. It's not a joker. But the mother didn't do that though. She turned and looked at me, hey Kersen, it's you. I like your shoes. You can fool. A whole big man like me. A whole big man. But I mean, it was a compliment, you know? Because my father, she said I could fool. She said, oh, God has blessed you. So I knew that there was something complimentary about being able to fool. But coming back to my point, it's creativity, whichever way you look at it. And to have a doctor, an eye doctor, to come and turn the place upside down through creativity and jokes, it's all part of what I'm talking about. Because having a creative eye should be encouraged not only to those studying so-called the arts, but to everyone. I think if you are studying medicine or physics, pharmacy, whatever you're studying, there should be an element of creativity or the creative arts that you need to understand. Because having that eye, having that critical eye, as Nadamwa has shown us, opens up your world to see things that people on the normal surface wouldn't see. He was talking about the Chinese. He was talking about Vietnam Singh. When you read in some pieces, he raises issues, discusses them very lightheartedly, but they are deep, they are incisive. And trust me, at the level of where we are as a developing nation, these are the kinds of eyes that we need to guide us. Creativity is the key to really look and understand, because there is danger ahead. There is. And it is true. Creativity that we can create the awareness for people to understand what is going on in a very fine way, but at least let them become aware. I'll tell you one quick story, then I'll end, of how a moment in my life just shocked me to reality. I was in the US then, and I was watching a Tarzan movie. And in that movie, there was a little white baby who had shipwrecked. So the baby was in the forest and left to the elements of nature. And we are all worried for this baby. Now in that movie, we had seen an African tribe or group in that movie. And also there was a family of apes or chimpanzees. But let me tell you what. The Africans were projected as primitives, savage, deadly, no humanity in them. However, we saw the apes, and the apes had their families, and they seemed to be taking care of their families, and there was a look of humanity in the apes. So the movie, as it went along, was that the baby would either be discovered by the apes or the Africans. And here I was, African man, at the movie theater, New York City, suspense in this movie, because I didn't know who was going to get to the white baby first, the Africans or the apes. But guess what? I was praying to God, oh God, let the apes get to me first. Why? Because I knew the baby would be in trouble if the Africans get to me. This is what I'm talking about. To find yourself as an African in a movie theater rooting for apes. Oh, by the way, your so-called people tells you a certain state of mind that you have and how you perceive yourself. I should have probably been angry at the portrayal of the African, but I accepted that image. And I was praying that they don't get to the baby because the baby will be safer with the apes. What is my long story about? I'm talking about the power of creativity. the power of the creativity to present something in such a way that it twists your mind and you realize that you are supporting animals of your own kind. This, in a nutshell, is what I mean by it's great to have people like the Nanada Moyes amongst us who see these things and use the same creativity to change things. We need that. At some time when I was in still back in the US, I think my mates were convinced that America had won the war in Vietnam. They lost. America lost in Vietnam. Why did they think America won? Why did they have the perception that America won? Rambo. Have you seen that movie? Where one man went and killed all the Vietnamese and came back and they won the war. I'm just drawing your attention to the power of creativity and how I wish that the Damoyes of this land would get to work and we get more of them, all of us, to start thinking of how to use this creative art and the power to create to change perceptions. When I read in St. Peter's, I was amazed. I was saying, yeah, so who am I? Because it draws my attention to the fact that we are a blend of so many ethnic groups or tribes that it's very, very hard to say, I am so and so and so. But we don't realize that. And we use tribalism as a key to insult, to, you know. My grandmother is from Mali. My grandmother's a fine Malian chick. Well, she was, you know. So let me end here by saying that, Adam, well, thank you very much. We need you. We need what you're doing because it's not art for art's sake. It's art with relevance. And with all respects, I respect art, and it's good to do art for art's sake. That's fine. That's your choice. But I beg, as much as we can, as artists, because of our particular circumstances that we live in, let us try and do art that creates awareness, art that can educate. Let us create films that we can watch and have our kids watch, and then films alone will give it themselves a sense of nationhood, a sense of vibrancy, a sense of direction, and not a sense of witchcraft and juju. What do you say? It's MP. Well, my mouth has fallen. It's MP. My mouth has fallen. Is it falling? Is it falling or shut? My mouth has fallen.
Thank you very much, KSM. Please show him some love. To learn from Kwapimpong, KSM is an Oprimpong, Ayankuntong, Atonuso, Nawapayakana, Utupong. Please meet us together for him once again. We are going to launch the book in St. Peter's. After that, we'll have what is known as every MC's nightmare. When I'll hold the book up and ask someone to give me 1,000 Ghana cedis, or better still, 1,000 pounds or 2,000 pounds. So I'll call Honorable Jifa Gomashi. Once a soldier, always a soldier. So that title will never leave you. KSM and Mr. PJ, the three of you, please move to the book to help us do the launch. And another one will join the three of you to launch the book.
My dear good brothers and sisters, I'm a nomad, close to 70 now.
Hello.
But I'm very, very happy getting this chemical engineer right now. So whatever I'm doing, whatever I'm sick or not. I told him to write him before I go to the grave. And I mean it. I'll see him before I die. Yes. I'm really very, very, very happy meeting people like KSM. I've been watching him closely. Yes. And many others. So, you see, I don't want to bore you. But the cost of the matter is that we are ready to line the book. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Hip, hip, hip. Hip, hip, hip.
For a journalist to shove his microphone in your hands means that he has nothing to say, he expects you to say something. And so, standing behind books, we can only say that we thank God for today. I will declare this book launched, and may we all gathered here make it possible for it to go to all the corners of the world. I thank you very much.
I have to make you do this because I've not received my ex gratia yet. If I launch it, people would expect me to buy it for, say, 10,000 Ghana cedis, which I'm not ready to. Please jump together for Jifa, KSM, and Mr. Plagi. It's time for us to auction this book. And I wish I had someone else to do this. Because at this point, even if you are promised a big hot bowl of food at home, you still won't have the vim to think about it and get excited because you have to clear that. So I would like to call Mr. H. Kwesi Prempe. I think I saw you earlier. He's gonna help me sell just two books. Yes. Please put your hands together for the astute lawyer. I think I saw him around here, and he'll come up to help me sell just two books. H. Kwesi Prempe. Where is he? Now, the first five books to buy the book is going to receive this from Letter on Call. We have photographer Kafui Breeze also taking photos. Please give us a wave. Oh, H. Kwesi Prempe is not here. Oh, he's here. Please give him, and I put it to you, applause as he comes up. To help me sell two of the books.
I have no idea. This guy put me on the spot. I was breaking my club. I was having fun
with my club. Okay, so club here is 1931. Let's take the 931 and leave the 1000. So the first goes for 1000 cities.
So 931.
Let's sell the first copy for 1000.
For 1000 cities. So 1000 cities.
Wait.
I want to go and finish my club, please. 1000 cities so I can go finish my club. Just 1,000 Ghana cedis. This is not pounds, this is not US dollars, this is not euros. We disavow all those currencies. We want just Ghana cedis. 1,000 Ghana cedis. Otherwise, my beer is going to stay out. My brother, you are rescued me. Wow. Easy job. Thank you so much. Wow. So the first book goes to quite appropriately too. Goes to our guest of honor for 1,000 series. It's my job now. Oh. One more.
Two books gone, a lot more to go. And when I explain in heaven, there is no beer. That's from the chief version. The chief version was performed by Samin. Okay, put your hands together for the name. Very good. I'm tempted to call another man to come here to auction one more book, but I'm afraid I'll call someone who's also drinking beer and distort the flow. But before I even sell the next book, I'm supposed to reserve this for the last, but good news should be shared, because we don't know when God will land. If God lands right now, we will not hear about this good news. So Aunt Jifa is buying 10 books for her library. Please put your hands together for her. So I'm giving all this to her. If you don't buy the rest of the books, I'll give all this to her. So who comes next? 500 Ghana cedis for a copy of the book. For those of you who are so rich and you don't want us to know you are that rich, don't worry. Just raise your hand. Our ushers will come to you. Whatever amount you have, just tell the usher, take the book, and give us a check, mobile money, or take an envelope and put it in it, or give us your card, you will take it. So, Bridget, should we come to you? Yes. Bridget, let's get around for 500 Ghana cedis. One more, 500. Where is the person? Please give us a word. Please take this to him. One more at the back, 500 CDs. More 500. One more, 500 Ghana cedis. If you know you posted any signs on Facebook today, put your hands up and take this of 500. I'll mention your name. We have one more, 500 Ghana cedis. Okay, if you are writing a check for the book, write the full name of the book on the check so that we can get it later. If you are writing a check, write the full name on the book. Ghana for Yepa Zonto. Ghana for Yepa Fufu. Ghana for Yepa Club. Yepa Fufu. By Nana Areka. So we won't buy. Let's go. So we are going down to 300 Ghana cedis. But if you want to go up to 2,000, don't worry. Talk to our ushers. They will give you the book and take whatever amount you have. So the name you have to write on the check is Nana Aredamwa, as it's written on the book. Nana Aredamwa.
So 300 Ghana cedis. 300 Ghana cedis can just give you maybe a week supply of 30 Ghana cedis pizza with no proper toppings. And this thing will give you a lifetime of enjoyment. So 300 Ghana cedis. If you know you have a verified Twitter account, please put your hands up. Ramitan has a verified Twitter account. I'll give him a copy of the book for 300 Ghana cedis. Please put your hands together for Ramitan. He's taking it. He didn't reject it, so Ramitan is taking one. Okay. I have a verified Twitter account, so I'll take one. So 300 Ghana cedis. Okay, okay, stop it. How many of you went to primary school in Ghana? How many of you went to primary school in Ghana? Because of 300 cedis, you won't put your answer. Hey! This attitude is the reason why Kunso is not growing. 300 Ghana cedis. Bridget, are you coming to help me? Okay. 300 Ghana cedis. Mr. Jonathan Akiman, I see you. How are you? How is Tema? Yeah, Jonathan is the unofficial mayor of Tema. I know he's buying a copy for 2,000 cedis, and he doesn't want you to know. 250 Ghana cedis. Giovanni Caleb. Giovanni of Star FM, Star Drive. Giovanni is getting a copy for 3,000 cedis. He doesn't want you to know. So please put your hands together for Giovanni Caleb. You are taking a copy. Is it 3,000 or 300? Okay, thank you very much, Giovanni. Please put your hands together for Giovanni. Oh, I was going to say Jalai. Izzy, are you here? Back then, when Jalai and Kojo Okonkoma were on the Super Morning Show, there was something they used to play. I don't know if they still do play it. Oh, Kojo, a full bouquet. Now, I went to Baltimore High Street, and I was eating Bupu as a coach cover. And a young girl comes and he says, oh, you are called Kojo. I hear you're a radio presenter. Are you the person who plays Oh Kojo and Tubu Kiri? So 250 Ghana cedis. You're looking at me like one. Ah, the check is ready. Ah, she's actually set the new price. 200 Ghana cedis. Please put your hands together for her. And the check is ready. Okay, 200 Ghana cedis. Oh, so we have Sek J. Bokwe on Facebook. He is coming to Kelly Bokwe. And he sent a special ambassador to tell me he's getting a copy of the book for 200 Ghana cedis. Please put your hands together for the 2013 journalist. He won an award. Is it education? Education, right? And health. Ghana journalist GJ Award. So Kwame, please come for your book. Let everybody see you a print one. From the Port Authority of Tarifa. Efola. Efoha. Please put your hands together for him. It's not easy to, you know, buy a book for 200 Ghana cedis. Thank you very much, Seth. Mamesi, should I give out more books? I should give out more books. So please pick some more books for me. Ah, you are picking a book. All right. What's your name? Selassie. What does it mean? No, don't worry. I didn't ask you that question. You are getting a copy of the book, right? For 200 Ghana cedis. Please put your hands together for Selassie. He picked a copy of the book for 200 Ghana cedis. Should I go up? Because some of you were still counting your money, or I should still drop down. Okay, is it Doom or Sock? Doom or Sock? Okay, so we'll go up to 150 Ghana cedis.
150. Please put your hands together for him. 150 Ghana cedis and all those who are getting the books, Nana will sign them later. 150. South Korea, just put your hands up there. Ashes will come to you, take a check. Mobile money, any of those. Cash, 150. 150 Ghana cedis. There's a hand up. Where? 150 Ghana cedis. Please put your hands together for the wife of KSM, Mrs. KSM. So they bought the first book for 1,000 Ghana cedis. I only acknowledge KSM, but behind every successful K, there's an SM, and she's actually an SM. And in the history of Ghana, SM means a lot of things, social media and shutter movement. So please put your hands together for Mrs. KSM. More books, eh? Should I drop to 1,000? Mr. Beje, do I have the permission to drop to 1,000? 100. Oh, I thought it was so, so you go up. I and my 100 are 100 Ghana cedis. Any answer? Oh, you don't have to play today, you can play later. You just, you know, or rather, say Ghana Pradika. So if somebody wants it, they want to play 100 Ghana. I and my 100 are 1. I and my 100. Why don't say the 100? No. The girls will not buy books at 100. Or even 200 or 300. Because they cannot mention 100. They say 100. So I'll take it to the thousands or the girls, you know. Because the 100. So 100 Ghana. Oh, that's one. Please take it to her. The lady in the where Ghana. Just there. Oh, take one more. Your partner don't come in. Show. Akoba. Please put some more books on me. 100. Oh, one at the back. Please take it to him. 100. There's one at the back. Please go to the back. 100 Ghana cedis. Mr. Ni Ayu Pakolanya. You know, hold on. Exactly 3 years ago, the then president, John Dramani Mahama, presented the State of the Nation address. And he acknowledged one brand that I've loved for the past 4 years, Horseman Shoes. The CEO of Horseman Shoes is here. And he's buying a copy of the book for 100 Ghana cedis. Please put your hands together for Tony Yasin for his book. Tony, you come and take your book 100. And an applause for Israel Ali. Tony says he'll buy more copies for his shop at Kokomremri, Fast Side Enterprise, Kokomremri, Papa, Zidia. 100. 100 Ghana cedis. Besiebi, onye neba, oko disco, wash yellow. My lady yellow, I see you. Oka sabe doji. 100. Oh, Ananeya Okuronu, please put your hands together for Mr. Okuronu. 100. 100 Ghana cedis. Ah, Ishala is buying one more. Ah, Ishala, where are Belma? Where are Belma? 100. 100 Ghana cedis. Teche Elo is getting one for 100 Ghana cedis. Please put your hands together for Elo. You know, as a fire officer, so we'll do the job. We're going to be able to get a man and boom. Please take it to Eno, 100 Ghana cedis. Put your hands together for Eno. If you are here and you work in a bank, and you are sitting there watching me talk about 100, 100, 100, and you are not getting your company, bring it down to me. Inflation, interest rates, you know, will be out here, but you will rising. Ah, Sarawako, put your hands together for Sarawako. Yeah, I know you have it already, but Kobe check. Kobe, high school for your child, yeah. We'll say what the high school, now who will be hey, please take one to Sarawako, where you're a big man. You head a department with about 500 people. Come back, go check your whole department. One is to 500. Please put your house together for him. I'm always in your talk. When I went to Kumasi High School, there was a name written on the wall. You know, Kumasi High School were very bad boys. I mean, there was a name written on the wall. It was Cashman. It was not until we were in third year that they came back for this back to school that we got to know that the Cashman is this man sitting there. It is some other character. Not a crowd at all. Aha, I can't know. I have 100 before I drop to 50. There's a hand at the back. Please, if your hand is up at the back and I can't see you, just say Onapo. If your hand is up and Onapo Bako. Take it to her. There's one at the back. I have one more here. $100. Now, what's the regular price of instant pieces? 30. So if I go to 60, that's fair, right? So Ghana is 60, so in the spirit of Ghana is 60. Ghana. 60 Ghana cedis. 60 Ghana cedis. 60. Emana Moana, Mukumo Stapana, which is a Mukumo Stapana, Stapana, Serena Jibaku. 60 Ghana cedis. Wow, which is a Mukumo Stapana. You have the best. That's for the hand. There's one here. There's one there, the lady in black. If you believe your husband is very fine and very rich, this is just for the ladies. Just put your hand up. Ah, Ivy. Okay, but Ivy, you are not married. And you are getting one. Or you are married and I don't know. This is just for the ladies who are married and you believe that your husband is very nice. Now, if you are a man here and you believe that your wife's cooking, the whole eastern part of West Africa is the best. Put your hands up. One for 60 Ghana cedis. One for down, someone will hear the buyer, I'll bet you over. So it's just 60 Ghana cedis. 60 Ghana. 60 Ghana, okay. 60 Ghana. We're almost done with the books. So let's do this fast. Mamisi, please fetch some more for me. 60 Ghana. This is the day. 5 million Ghanaians who will be Queen Elizabeth and Prince Philip will be here that special day. We will buy goods and go pay. We will put on 25 on this special instant pieces at Jamrock. May God bless this one Saturday. When everybody will buy a book. None of them will we love you. I love you. Ah, 100, no, 60 Ghana cedis. I thought it was 100. Hold this for me. Okay, two more to go. So we are not dropping any further. Just two more. Mama and I are there. It's two more. Oh, then, they want a song, eh? Give them one song to ginger them to buy the last two. 60 Ghana. Brian, Mark. Let's say. 60 Ghana. Just. When they drop here, you know what? No, 60. 60. 60 Ghana there. Please help. That lady is the one for 60. Last one. Ah, nice one. 60 Ghana. Please put your hands together for yourselves. It's kind of amazing. We saw it on the cruise. Put your hands together for yourselves. I said, there are. Come out. Don't do it.
So there are more books at the back. We are going for 30 Ghana cedis. So you can put them at the back and buy for 30 Ghana cedis. Amara will sign them for you. Mami, if you are here, get ready. You'll give us a vote of thanks. We sold all the books, so get ready for the vote of thanks. This song in 2017, we'll start with there. Huh? What else? Give us the money, no big problem. Huh? Yes! We'll have more music, but we'll do that after the vote of thanks and the closing prayer. So please, let's welcome Mami Ekia T. Yosef to come up and give us a vote of thanks. Mami, an applause for her, please.
A very good evening to everyone. I honestly felt really cool and grown up when God asked me to give the vote of thanks. It really is a privilege to be before you all this evening. First and foremost, an expression of gratitude goes to our Father Almighty upstairs, the one who makes all things beautiful at this time. I'm forever grateful for this time he's given us. A time for us to converge as a family, drink up here in Sobolu, and remember our beloved Ghana as seen in the Book of the Night. For the captain of tonight's ship, the MC, I say a warm thank you. Your mannerisms and helm-turning skills are those that will be with us for a very long time. Thank you. A special thank you is in order to the ever lovely Tufa Gomashi, our chairperson, for accepting to be our gold medalist for the evening. Indeed, your presence has been felt a great deal this evening. To Uncle KSM, who I can't find at the moment. I was super thrilled when I saw you listen to me read right now. Not because you are experienced in fooling, but just because you are KSM. I appreciate your presence with us tonight, and I'm certain that everyone pretty much feels the same. Thank you. After all these thank yous and dances, nothing would be complete without these words of gratitude. Nat, thank you for liking Plenty and Sense and for compiling them into a book, without which our family gathering would not have been possible. Lastly, to every single soul seated here this very minute, thank you for gracing this moment with your presence and for loving books just as we do. To the beautiful person you are and the outstanding bibliophile within you, I say, Aiko. Thank you.
Thank you. Please put your hands together for Mami. In fact, if I have a final copy of the book, I'll have kept it here to auction for 1,000 Ghana. Because no one can eat. For very young flowers. And then to a pop to circle or support the end. And I said, see, I'm not being a tummy. How do you say? And if you're a guy, how do you say? Aha. The whole eastern part of West Africa. Now, I'm looking at the program lineup, and there's nothing like chairperson's closing remarks because I omitted it. But since we've thanked you already, I still believe, well, I'm not going to say anything, so we've thanked you already, but we can still call you up here to give the closing remarks. So, Atijipa, please come up and give us the closing remarks. Please put your hands together for her.
Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, Dr. Obi,
No, I'm still standing here thinking that 50 is the new 25. And then the man comes to stand here and says that KSM would like to look at each other that he likes all their old clients. And they are 50 and so on. Not an answer. Hey, you just demoralize the two of us. 50 is the new 25. Why did we do that again? We have been enriched. We have been fed by Nana Ared Damboa. We had a three-course meal. The first course was reading from the books. The second course, the main dish, was a speech by Kirsten. And the dessert has been served by Nene, Obi, Theo, Celestine, my beautiful sister, and of course, the adorable MC. And Kojo, your MC ship is just one of a kind. You are amazing. You truly are. My dear Bridget, are you here? That question about not knowing about authors made me a bit sad, because every month a day is set up for the Ghana Association of Writers, and we meet at the powerhouse by Roman Ridge near Accra Girls. So I think isn't that so? And authors come, and writers as well, people who write poetry and so on. And we share a wonderful time on a Sunday afternoon. And so for any other journalist who's here and doesn't know that we have that session, please be informed. It will be nice to see all of you patronize the Ghana Association of Writers event. I like to be there because you hear the kinds of things that people are doing and you are inspired and motivated. The other part of what Bridget asked is the fact that here in Ghana, we like to just celebrate other people's way of life. It includes the food that other people eat in their countries. Instead of a wakula or a umuhum, anam pihum, we like to wear other people's clothes and not ours. Everybody has a bad day. So Ghana has its bad day every now and again. Every city has its slums, and Ghana has its also. But strangely, I joined Minister Otakun in saying this, not on the food bit, but on the part that says that we like to just celebrate the negativity of our people and never the positive ones. Perhaps if the number of us who are here make a decision today that we are joining Nana Ared Damboa to write about the positives about our country and to just celebrate the little things. The beautiful ushers in their atofo and the beat and all. If we just admire them because they speak to a part of us, if we are not ashamed of our heritage and who we are, if we look at our story and pick something that is edifying and share it with someone else, Perhaps the journey that we are on to making our country what we want it to be will be shorter than it is right now. I asked our friends in Nigeria when I visited there during the African Magic US Choice Awards why they don't show me places like the Victoria Islands, a very beautiful place. But they show me all these maidens who are either being bewitched or are getting rich only because they are getting involved with black magic or practicing black magic. We must learn to tell good stories about ourselves. We must learn to celebrate the little strides that we make. KSM told us that it starts from the mind. What is it that makes it possible for us not to find anything wrong with littering our environment? What is it that makes it okay to disrespect people who have charted the path that you and I are walking on? What is it that makes it so easy? Those are the kinds of things that Nana Ared Damboa has written in his piece. The summer the adults of 18 so. Yeah, see, when you man, you can't see, who's young swap, what's there? You're still not swap, who's now, who's not, what's there?
So let us continue teaching each other. Let's continue inspiring each other, and let's learn. And what we learn, let's pass it on to the next generation. You and I have a role to play in making this country what we want it to be. As authors, as readers of what the authors have written, as believers in this country, let us all put our shoulders to the wheel. It is possible for us to push this country further and higher than it already is. I thank you very much for enduring with me, standing behind the microphone. Go out there, spread the word. Let's help sell Isepism and all the other books that the Dapabli authors have been writing. I see Abba here. She's also an amazing writer. Is Ruby Gova here too? Oh, she has a program after that. Oh, yeah, sure. I saw her on Facebook. But we do have amazing writers in our country. Elizabeth, of course, she came over to say hello. So we have people who are writing, but if we don't write, we will not inspire them to write some more. So let's keep purchasing what they produce. God bless our homeland, Ghana. Thank you very much.
Thank you. And we were honored to have you here with us. God bless you. I hope next week we'll get to the beaches and start cleaning as usual. Yes. Nana, you want to say something before we go?
Thank Alex of your shoe.
Yeah, because the person who makes my shoes is a typical elder boy. But he loves Amachi Dede more than any Kumasi boy. So I wore brown for Volta and black for Ashanti. Yes, that was my shoes. Okay, so Name's book set, all the six books, he's bundled them together and he's going for 200 Ghana cedis per. So if you want to buy, if you don't have any of the books, this is your chance to get a copy for yourself. No copies of all the books actually for 200 Ghana cedis at the back. Peter Bradshaw of Joy FM, please come. Please come. You are writing on Facebook that you were scared my head will hit the mic. Please come. Now, I'm scared for you because I have to say the closing prayer. So please, put your hands together for him to say the closing prayer.
But I'm so scared, you know, standing by him. The way he was shaking his head, I was like, hey, my brother. But we finished the same school, but I think he was my senior, but it's all good. Who? All right, shall we close our eyes and stand, please? Thank you. Our Father in heaven, we thank you this evening. We adore your name. We thank you for bringing us together to come and witness in St. Peter's, written by Ghana Aredamwa. But as we gathered here, we know we've learned a lot from what he has written. What we ask of you is to bless him more and have favor upon him so I can write more books for us to buy. I pray that you also put a surge on his books so that we can have enough money to buy so much of his knowledge and share with our friends. We thank you, Lord, this evening. We thank you for our gathering. We thank you for the friends we've made. Thank you for the drinks we've had, the food we've eaten, and the new friends we're making. Bless us, Lord. Thank you. Amen.
Amen. Please put your hands together for him. When he said, bless us, I nearly said, with success and a couple of things. Because we have a couple of things at the back. We have refreshment at the back. So please, whilst we stand, let's observe a minute's silence for the beer you are going to drink, the soap alone, and the food and everything. Please, a minute's silence. And the fun you are going to have afterwards. May they rest in perfect peace. Amen. Thank you very much for coming. There is music, there's refreshment, and there's a whole lot more. Then are you ready? Tony, you are the after party. Come and sing a match of the day. I don't prepare my name, but so that's what I heard you. Okay, I'm going to say, I don't be a silent. Say,
So we are taking pictures. You can get more books at the back. And there is so below, there is beer, there is food. Get some food from Jamrock, enjoy their food. Special thanks going out to Jamrock, Multi-Pixel, Thai Pickles, White and Club Beer, Naughty Store Balloon, Store Factory, AJ's Cleaning Services, Astro Impact, Leather of Crop, Bobby Play, Toby K, Aruka, Apple Kuntra Mesa, Kafu Froze, Threadex, and check here and go to better.
Everybody, do what you do. Oh my God.
I'm going to go to the hospital. Thank you.